Madam Speaker, I want to start by Madam Speaker, I want to start by thanking all the honourable members who have taken the floor to support the provisions of the bill. Madam, this bill provides protection against punitive action on a number of categories, and unless this bill is passed by 31st December, Delhi will witness unprecedented chaos. And some of the chaos was started by my friends across the in the Congress party, whose actions for the many years that they were in power resulted in irresponsible, unauthorized constructions, etc., and failure of governance of a very high order. Madam, let me start by explaining the history of this issue. When India became an independent country, Delhi's population was less than 10 lakhs. In the 1951 census, Delhi's population had gone up to 17 lakhs because of the ravages of the partition and the number of people who had come in from across the border. According to the 2011 census, Madam, Delhi's population was 167 lakhs. And according to the estimate today, which is the figure for 2016, Delhi's population should be around 186 lakhs. Today, we are witnessing phenomenal growth. This growth has consequences. These consequences are reflected in encroachment of public land, in the growth of slums, in unauthorized constructions, large-scale commercialization of residential areas, and inadequacy of housing. The master plan of 2021, which was finalized in 2007, shows that the population of Delhi in 2021 will be 2.30 crores. During this period, Madam, a large number of people, something like 22 lakhs, have come in from other states within the country. We also have a large number of people who have come in from outside the country. These are issues which are being dealt with separately. The Delhi Laws Special Provisions Act was enacted in order to be able to provide cover against punitive action. This bill today seeks to amend on an as-is, where-is basis the law which was enacted in 2011. It was enacted, extended till 2014. Then up to 2014, it went to 2017. And today, in 2017 Act, is being extended on an as-is, where-is basis till 2020, 31st December. The only two changes that are being brought in is that of the seven categories, which I will read out, in one of the categories, in respect to street vendors, we already have separate legislation which will provide protection to street vendors. These seven categories are slum dwellers and jhuggi jhompadi clusters, urban street vendors, which is proposed to be omitted from the bill now, unauthorized colonies, village abadi areas, including urban villages and their extensions, existing farmhouses involving construction beyond permissible building limits, schools, dispensaries, religious and cultural institutions, storages, warehouses, and godowns built on agricultural land and existing godowns, special areas, walled city extension and Karol Bagh, all other areas within the national capital area of Delhi. Madam, why are we seeking this extension? Speaking on this bill, my distinguished predecessor in December 2017 said that it will be his best endeavor not to have to come back to seek an extension. But the Honorable Member Shri Dushyant Chautala, while speaking, says that this is the failure of governance. I want to remind him that the central government, according to a directive of the Honorable Supreme Court, is required to interact in a consultative process with the government of Delhi, DDA and other authorities in order to be able to frame policies, devise guidelines and ensure orderly arrangement. The Delhi government, I want to remind the Honorable Member Shri Dushyant Chautala, that the Delhi government gave an affidavit before this High Court in September this year, saying that they require 2 more years in order to be able to complete the delineation of what is an unauthorized colony and what is the authorized in terms of the cut-off dates which are provided. Now, one of the problems that we are facing is that meanwhile, there is a separate sealing process which the Honorable Supreme Court has started on. Therefore, this bill only deals with the issues which this bill has dealt with in the past. That is an as-is, where-is extension of the bill of 2017. The only two amendments that are being made are to substitute the words up to 31 December 2017 by up to 31 December 2020 and removal of the street vendors legislation, because on that we have a separate legislation which has already seen the light of day and which will afford protection. Some of the members raised the issue of the unauthorized encroachment on DDA land and the demolition of the so-called hostel for blind students. I want to set the record straight, madam. This was a hostel constructed on unauthorized, this was an unauthorized construction on DDA land. They were provided not one, but 4 notices in order to shift. We offered, not we, the DDA offered the few blind students who were there to shift them to an adjoining hostel for blind students. But for a variety of reasons, they decided to make this an issue in the press. Let me explain. This was an incident which took place on December 15th, which is more than 12 days ago to be exact. Now we have a situation in which a temporary Hutmats facility, which was pulled down, the students are being already shifted to a proper hostel nearby, but the students are being made the excuse. And as I mentioned to the Honorable Member when he spoke to me, that this is not an issue of the blind students there. They were only a few of the inmates, but they were already offered to be housed in proper school for the blind children in a nearby proper facility. But there is somebody taking advantage of this situation in order to run an unauthorized facility. I want to also come, Madam Speaker, to one or two other issues which have been raised here. One of the issues raised by an honorable member has been the equalization of the conversion charges or the misuse charges, which were earlier 89,000 rupees. And apparently today, the discussions with the monitoring committee, in which Shri Bhurilal and another honorable member are participating, there have been some discussion that those affected by this ceilings could pay an interim charge of 25%, which is 22,000 rupees by way of a misuse charge as part of an undertaking till the issue is finally settled. Madam, we are dealing with that issue. Several other issues have been raised by honorable members, including on issues which may be residual issues which are not covered by all the 7 categories that I have mentioned. 6 now, because the whole business about street vendors is now covered by a separate legislation. What I can say, Madam Speaker, is that we are in a position now, after the passage of this bill, I will consult the Law Ministry, I will consult all the others in the party and see if there are any residual issues. But what we need to do is to ensure that within the time of extension that we will be provided by the passage of this bill today, that all the procedures are completed in consultation with the Delhi State Government and the other multi-stakeholders who are involved in the process, so that we can finally get Delhi back to authorized construction. And I must confess that I was struck by some of the language used by the Supreme Court in its judgment on 15th December, when Justice Lokur said, "Invaders have pillaged Delhi for hundreds of years, but for the last couple of decades, it is being ravaged by its own citizens and officials governing the city capital." And I want to appeal to all citizens through your good offices, Madam, and to those who have been in the governance role in Delhi, to now assume a more responsible role and to try and cooperate, so that this plunder and pillaging of Delhi, which has gone on for so many decades, including under their governance, that this is rectified, I move now, madam, that the bill be adopted.